Hi, I'm Hannah Martin from Bobbi Brown's Global Beauty Team, and I'm here today with you and your wedding creating some gorgeous bridal looks. And today we're focusing on coral makeup. So we've already prepped our gorgeous model Olivia here with some of the new Bobbi Brown BB cream. It's super lightweight but gives a really pretty flawless finish. I've topped up with a little bit of foundation stick just for those areas where you might need a little bit of extra coverage. I've also done some corrector and concealer under the eye. So ladies, please remember you must ensure your under eye area is nice and bright and clean for your wedding so that you look as fresh as possible in your photographs. I've also done a little bit of bronzer. To avoid getting too much brown through the center of the face, we've just swept the bronzer over the top of the cheeks, back out into the temple. Remember, if you've got your hair up, just take your bronzer brush over your ears and maybe a little bit behind, and then also just dust it over the top of the forehead as well, so you're bronzed up where the sun would naturally hit. Now for the coral look, you can wear a bit more bronzer than you may normally if you want to, because it will tie in with the look really beautifully. So we need to start adding a bit of colour, and I'm going to do that with a Bobbi Brown Pot Rouge, and this is the fabulous Calypso Coral. So it's a pink infused coral colour that is so pretty and great for a really gorgeous summer wedding, especially if you've got a bit of a tan. So to apply this, I'm using a foundation brush that I've tapped into the cream. And for placement, always smile and place your foundation brush on the top of the apple of the cheek and then blend out to meet your bronzer. So I just took off some excess product on the back of my hand. Beautiful. Then make sure you use your finger just to blend it into the skin. Beautiful. So we've done the cream blusher and we're going to move on to some lip colour, and I've chosen the Bobbi Brown lip colour in Carnation, which is a soft coral tone. It's not too orange, so it's not going to look too bright or too dated. Be careful not to opt for a coral lipstick that's too brightly orange, because I think sometimes it can look, yeah, a little out of date. So we've gone for a pretty mid-coral here in Carnation. Lovely. And just blend that over the lips. You can go straight from the bullet if you're more confident like that, but I would always suggest you use a lip brush for greater precision. And this lip colour is nicely in colour harmony with the cheek colour. And that's a good tip when you're doing your bridal makeup. If you use a pinky blush, try and match it to a pinky lip colour. It'll just be more pleasing to the eye. It won't jar at all. Pretty. Okay. So now we're going to move on to the eyes. And I'm going to start with a base colour, and it's a Bobbi Brown Longwear Cream Eyeshadow in a colour called Sandy Gold. And I'm using this because they're so long wearing that you just won't have to worry about touching up your eye makeup. Once these gels go on, they dry completely waterproof, so they're an absolute must for a wedding, especially if you're getting married at the height of summer during wedding season, or if you're getting married abroad. Great for beach weddings. So I'm going to apply that with a cream shadow brush, and we'll sweep it all the way along the lower lid for a very pretty soft gold shimmer. It's not metallic though, so don't panic about it being too shiny for flash photography. This will just have a soft glint. So take it all over the lower lid and just take your brush through the crease. We'll repeat the same on the other eye. I'm using a cream shadow brush to apply this product, and I'd highly recommend it, as you'll find if you use a natural hair shadow brush in the cream, you'll actually just ruin your brush because the cream will get stuck in the hair. So I highly recommend a synthetic brush to apply this with. Pretty. So we're going to take a little bit of powder shadow now and press it in on top. And I'm going to use a couple of shades. I'm going to start with this pretty rose gold colour. So it's a soft peachy pink, and we'll just take a little bit of that through the lid. And don't be alarmed, this is such a pretty peachy pink that it's not going to be too pink for your photographs. If you find a shadow that's quite blue pink, I'd say it's pretty, but steer clear of it for your wedding. You don't want any colour that could potentially make your eyes look tired or sore. Great. And now I'm going to move into a little bit of burnt sugar. Again, a lovely soft bronzy colour. And we'll just take a little bit of that and just push it a wee bit along the lash line. So just pushing it right into the bottom of your lid, just to give it a slightly deeper goldy look. I'm just going to take my eye blender brush and just sweep under the eyes, just to sweep away any fallout that you may have had. Great. And we're going to take a little bit of that liner, of this bronze colour, as a liner underneath the eye. So I'm using an angled shadow brush because it's got a slightly firmer tip. So I'm going to get a bit of the bronze on there, just tapping off the excess each time. And if you look up, we'll just blend a bit of that under the lashes for a soft bit of definition. Okay, so now we'll line the eyes, and I'm going to use a eyeliner pencil, but I'm going to use one of the Bobbi Brown longwear eye pencils, and they're great for two reasons. Firstly, the nib is super soft, so you don't have to work to apply it. You just have to do the faintest, lightest of strokes for a really good colour lay down. And also, it's longwear, so once it's on again, it dries waterproof and won't budge. I'm going to use a brush to soften the line once I've done it. And I'm going to use an eye definer brush to do that. So it's a slight angled brush, but it's quite stiff, so it'll move this product nicely. Always ensure, ladies, that you've sharpened your pencil before you go to use it, just to make it easier for you. And then take the tip of your liner and push it right into the base of the lashes. And I'm doing a technique of doing lots of little dots and little strokes right the way along the lash line, and then building them together to get the desired look I'm looking for. Great, always ensure you get your liner right to the outside corner of the eye. Great, and then with my brush, I'm just gonna go over that and just pull it up slightly. You have to get to work on this rather quickly, because as I said, they're long wear and they dry waterproof, so if you don't do it straight away, you'll find that your liner has set So we've defined the top lash line much stronger than we've done the lower lash line, and that's to ensure that your top liner looks much significantly stronger than your bottom liner, so that your eyes look lifted and bright. But if you would like a bit of extra definition under your lash line, you can still use the pencil, but I would suggest you take your definer brush and scrub a bit of the pencil from the nib onto the brush, and then with that, you can just take a little bit and just push it under the lash line. And you'll achieve with that a much softer underline than you would if you just went straight from the pencil to the skin under the eye. So we want to finish with lashings of mascara. Remember, ladies, to get out your waterproof mascara for the day. Look down for me. And we're gonna work it through the lashes. Zigzag at the base of the lashes to get your wand right in between, and make sure you get coverage from lash right to tip for maximum definition. And then I always think it's a good idea just to do a little on your lower lashes, so I'm just going to take a touch on the tip of my brush and just get a bit of coverage on the lower lashes too. Pretty. So to finish off, I'm just going to add a little bit of highlight to the cheek with a Bobbi Brown shimmer brick, and I'm going to use one of my favourite colours, and that's the Nectar. And the Nectar brick is perfect for the coral look because it is in fact a kind of golden peachy undertone. So I'm going to use that with a face blender brush. It's nice and it's not too dense a brush, so you won't end up with too much pigment on the skin. As you can see, it's got those gorgeous corally colours. So the technique for applying shimmer brick is to swirl your brush over the palette of colours. Remember always to tap off any excess colour so you don't have too much on your brush, and then just swirl or sweep the brick over the top of the cheek. And Bobbi actually calls these an accent your makeup. So maybe you don't always need to wear blusher, but Bobbi would suggest you wear a bit of blusher and then accentuate it with a bit of shimmer brick. So shimmer brick over the cheek is so pretty. It gives a real soft focus finish to your cheeks in your photographs, which is lovely. My advice is though, don't go too crazy with it. You don't need shimmer brick everywhere. Pretty. It's pretty though if you did want some, say, just over your collarbone. With your brush, dust the excess or remnants powder over your chest and shoulders, especially when you're wearing a strapless gown like this one. So there we have our finished coral-inspired bridal look. We've gone for soft golds and peaches on the eyes, married with a soft coral cream blusher and another corally pink lip carnation. Remember, ladies, when you're doing a colour theme like coral, to try and keep your colours all in colour harmony with each other so that they blend really nicely and they look really harmonious on the skin. Great look for any summer wedding, especially a beach wedding.